after the superconductive composite heat pipes found in the Hyper 612 Apex that I have recently evaluated, Cooler Master went to the 3D heat pipe technology for the fresh V4 Alpha and Hyper 212 coolers. To easily distinguish, Cooler Master added the 3DHP word at the end of their model numbers. According to Cooler Master, this new design adds a heat pipe and in a previously unused space to boost cooling performance and reduce noise by expanding surface contact and accelerating heat dissipation. Both new coolers use just two heat pipes, hence CM's motto, less is more, but because of the latest design, these two heat pipes offer higher performance than a standard duo of heat pipes. The models that I'm going to evaluate in this review are Hyper 212 3DHP Black, Hyper 212 3DHP Black ARGB, and V4 Alpha 3DHP Black. All use the same heatsink, but with some differences in the cooling fans. To find out the differences along with its adjusted prices, look at this table. 3DHP adds extra heat pipe ends and T-joints to pull heat from areas a standard U-pipe misses and to speed liquid return. By expanding pickup and return paths, it boosts effective heat transfer. In controlled tests, a two-pipe 3DHP layout can meet the temperature targets of typical four-pipe coolers. The additional pipe end is strategically placed to counter CPU heat spots and still balance the performance along the entire pipe, according to Cooler Master's claims. Since 3DHP technology uses fewer pipes, the fin stack is less congested and airflow can be smoother, which helps reduce noise. Key advantages of the 3DHP technology. I used Cooler Master's description for the following on purpose, but I also provide my take after that. Less reliance on extra heat pipes, more performance from more innovative design, less compromise, more reliability, less turbulence in the fin stack, more quiet cooling. Cooler Master states the three advantages that I just mentioned. I can understand that fewer heat pipes can indeed increase reliability since fewer things can go wrong. Still, the fact is that once the final product is out of the production line, very few things can break a heat pipe since it doesn't have any moving parts except for the liquid inside. Regarding the reduced turbulence in the fin stack because of fewer heat pipes, but you still have two tubes in the middle since each 3DHP heat pipe actually has three tubes now in the fin stack instead of only two. So, in essence, two 3DHP heat pipes have the same tubing in the fin stack as three normal heat pipes. I think Cooler Master's marketing should use smarter marketing terms to explain the advantages of 3DHP technology. What I need you to remember from all above, in case anyone asks you, is according to Cooler Master, 3DHP keeps the heat pipe approach and focuses on efficiency inside each pipe instead of adding more pipes. 3DHP asks each pipe to do its job better. 3DHP lowers measured thermal resistance versus a conventional pipe of the same diameter. In practical terms, coolers using 3DHP can hit the same temperature targets as plain coolers, but with fewer heat pipes. Since I already talked too much, let's skip the unboxing and in general the package information and move to the installation part. As I mentioned already, all coolers use the same heatsink. The coolers come with two sets of mounting brackets, one for AMD systems and another for Intel. Two screws found in a separate plastic bag are used to secure these brackets to the base of the heatsink. To install the cooler on the AMD system, the four screws are aligned with the motherboard and they are tightened. Alignment was easy, and there was clear tactile feedback to indicate when the cooler was fully secured. Once the cooler was tightened down, the fans were reattached using the clips. The process for the Intel system is always a bit more cumbersome, as you need to align the backplate while securing the heatsink. The good alignment of the thumb screws with the backplate helped with the installation. However, other coolers that secure the brackets on the back plate and then the cooler to the brackets make the installation on Intel even easier or better. On the other hand, the design found here removes the load from the screws that mount the cooler to the brackets as the arms sit above the coolant's base and push it down on the CPU. There is no offset for either AMD or Intel sockets, and this looks weird given the notable performance increase that offset mounting offers to these sockets. Lastly, the convex design of the cooling base plate offers better contact to CPU head speeders with concave designs while testing inside the climate chamber. To check my test methodology, better go to the corresponding or any recent cooling review on my site, hwbusters.com. On the same site, you will also find the full frequency plots and noise recordings of all three coolers. Noise output at 100% speed. It is among the lowest in the air coolers realm. Even the V4, which has a pair of fans, manages to keep the noise difference from the single fan 212 3DHP coolers at a low level, meaning that the common heatsink doesn't notably affect the fan's output noise. Overall performance, Intel. The overall performance is highly competitive at 20 decibels, but at higher noise levels, the performance gap widens with the top performing Noctua cooler. Remember the price difference between the NHD15 G2 and the Cooler Master coolers. Performance per price charts. With prices ranging from $30 to $40, the performance per price ratios are sky high compared to the super expensive Noctua NHD15 G2. Compared to this Noctua cooler, everything will look good though regarding performance per price. Overall performance, AMD. The overall performance is decent but not competitive. It looks weird that the Hyper 212 Black achieves higher overall performance than the V4 Alpha at 20 and 25 decibels, but the fact is that the average CPU frequency is notably higher, providing a performance boost. There is no point in only looking at the CPU temperatures, especially in the AMD platform, where with most coolers they are kept at close to 95 degrees Celsius. Performance per price. Thanks to the fair prices, the performance to price ratios are pretty high. Cooler Master introduced a new heat pipe technology called 3D heat pipe technology in the V4 Alpha 3DHP Black and the Hyper 212 3DHP Black and ARGB products. The central asset of these new products is depicted in the highly affordable prices. With just $30 and $40, you get more than decent performance and bulletproof fans, compared to the $150 to $180 that the Noctua NHD15 G2 costs, the new Cooler Master coolers are in a whole different price point. But there is also thermal light in the cooling field with some crazy prices that don't exceed $40, even for dual tower design coolers. This means that things won't be so easy for the new Cooler Master coolers even at the current price levels. Higher performance levels would help them stand out from the crowd. At a 25 decibel normalized noise output, a level that won't bother most users, while still allowing for good performance, the new Cooler Master coolers offer decent performance. The Arctic Freezer 36 offers higher performance, but it also calls the Arctic Freezer 36 offers higher performance, but it also costs $5 to $15 more. But at prices below $40, you can also find dual tower design thermal light coolers offering notably higher performance at the expense of compatibility with RAM modules that have head speeds higher than the average. That is all, guys. Bye bye.